Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Hallelujah.
You believe that? If you believe it, say it like you believe it. Hallelujah, Christ is risen. So, Christ is risen. We're here today to celebrate that resurrection on this Easter Sunday. Welcome all of you who are here. Welcome to the folks who are and will be joining us at home on our recorded worship service. Again, we're thankful to be able to gather here today while we are still observing the COVID-19 protocol, which for one thing means no singing. We do have some verses that we will read in our bulletin this morning, but we are still warned against congregational singing as apparently that can really cause the spread of the virus even more. A word about communion this morning. I know some of you weren't here to the first couple of times we've done this. You should have gotten a little baggie with a communion set in that when you came in this morning. The way to operate that is push down on the tab in the front, and that will release the top seal, which is about the thickness of a piece of scotch tape. And then, if you follow my lead, when I take the host, you take the host as well. I will say the body of Christ given for you. Then you can open the other seal. When I take the wine, you take the wine. I will say the blood of Christ shed for you. And then we have to put it back in the baggie, because that will keep our cleanup to a minimum. So a little different way that we are observing and celebrating communion, but a way that we're able to do that safely and do it all together. And one final note, as we gather this morning, just a reminder that even though our worship services have been limited, our weekly operations here in the church have been curtailed a little bit, our ministry here at St. Mark's still goes on. Which means your financial support is still very important. There are a couple ways you can do that. We have a box out under the handicapped entrance where you can drop off offerings. You can put them in the mail, send them here to the church. Again, you know, not to sound like a money grabber, but we do need money to operate. So please see that that financial service or financial stewardship is kept up. Are there any other announcements we should be aware of this morning? Let us prepare for worship.
Thank you.
is risen today. Alleluia. Christian, hasten on your way. Alleluia. Offer praise with love repeat. Alleluia. At the paschal victim's feet. Alleluia. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Just as God's work of creation never ends, so the gifts received in baptism are renewed every day. Let us give thanks together for the life given in baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for the waters of life, for water to bathe in, water to drink, for waters to play in, and waters that inspire wonder, for water that gives life to our planet. We give you thanks, O God, for the waters of life. We give you thanks, O God, for the waters of this place, for water from our tap, for rain and snow, for the Susquehanna River and its tributaries. We give you thanks, O God, for the waters of this place. We give you thanks for your salvation through water, for delivering Noah and his family through the floodwaters, for leading your people Israel through the sea into freedom, for preserving your prophet Elijah through the time of drought, for guiding your people across the Jordan into a new land, for quenching the Samaritan woman's thirst with living water. We give you thanks for your salvation through water. We give you thanks for the life of all the baptized and for all who gather here, for godparents, baptismal sponsors, children, and grandchildren, for our brothers and sisters in Christ whom we have never seen, but to whom we are bound. We give you thanks for life of all the baptized. We give you thanks for life in Christ through your Holy Spirit, for our entry into Jesus' death through these waters, for our new birth into a life of freedom and service, for our calling to be your people, sent out for the life of the world. We give you thanks, blessed and holy Trinity, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Worthy is Christ, the Lamb who was slain, whose blood set us free to be people of God. Power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and blessing and glory are His. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Sing with all the people of God and join in the hymn of all creation. Blessing and honor and glory and might be to God and the Lamb forever. Amen. This is the feast of victory for our God, for the Lamb who was slain has begun his reign. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us pray. O God, you gave your only Son to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, and by his glorious resurrection you delivered us from the power of death. Make us die every day to sin, that we may live with him forever in the joy of the resurrection. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Peter began to speak to the people. I truly understand that God shows no partiality. that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The Lord is with you.
Thank you, God.
Second reading of 1 Corinthians. Now I would remind you, brothers and sisters, for the good news that I proclaim to you, which you in turn receive, for which you also stand, to which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaim to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I came to you as of first importance what I in turn have received. That Christ died for us in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures, that he appeared to Cephas, and as well, that he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, those who were still alive, and some who died. Then he appeared to James, and to my apostles. Last of all, and one time ago, he appeared also to me. For I am least of the apostles, unfit to be called apostles, because I persecuted the Church of God. But by the grace of God, I am by him, and his grace toward me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I work hard to me, so it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so we have come to believe.
Thank you, God.
I'd like to stand as you're able. Hallelujah. Christ, our Pastor, has been sacrificed. Therefore, we have received the peace. Hallelujah. The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 16th chapter. Glory to you, Lord. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices, so that they might go and anoint Jesus' body. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe, sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. So he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, here is the place they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, where terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. Please be seated. Welcome home. I want to gather the children around. I have my usual children's audience here this morning. Welcome. Good to have you with us. So, the story I just read about Easter, you know, you guys have heard the story about Jesus dying. He rose from the dead. Now he lives. But if you notice something very odd at the end of the story, when those women came and they found that Jesus was no longer in the tomb, and the angel told them that Jesus had risen from the dead like he said, and the angel said, "Go and tell everybody." But you remember what the women did? They didn't say anything. They said they ran away from the tomb and didn't say anything to anybody because they were afraid. You think that today people might be afraid to talk to people about Jesus? Yeah, I think sometimes we are, right? Whenever we come here to church and we hear the story about Jesus and we hear about Jesus being risen from the dead and how he gives us new life and all those wonderful things, we want to run out there and tell everybody. But sometimes we know. Sometimes we are maybe more embarrassed than afraid because people might not believe what we believe. They might not agree with us, and so they're going to argue with us. Sometimes people might actually get very angry with us if we start to tell them about Jesus, and so we're afraid to tell them. But you know what's really amazing? Those women must not have stayed silent for very long. Because if they didn't tell anybody, maybe nobody would ever have heard about Jesus rising from the dead. And we wouldn't be here today either. So even though they were afraid for a while, they knew that it was too good to keep themselves. They couldn't keep Jesus' resurrection a secret. So we can remember that same thing. Sometimes we might be afraid to talk about Jesus. Sometimes we might be embarrassed to tell people about Jesus. But once we start to do it, and once you do it more and more, it's easier and easier. And you start to find out that a lot of people are very glad to hear that story. So whenever you can, tell people about Jesus. Remind them about him being raised from the dead and how he did that for all of us. And then we can start to spread good news about Jesus, just like those ladies in our story, eventually. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for Jesus' resurrection. We thank you for those who have shared that story throughout the centuries, and for the faith that we have in him because he rose from the dead, that he did that because he loves us so much. Help us always to tell that story and share that love wherever we go. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you very much. Grace to you and peace this morning from God the Father, and the Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. When Saturday was almost over, Lorraine Mariner, Johnny, the mother of Deb, and Jeannie laid out their Sunday best clothes so that they would be ready for church on Easter morning. Early on Sunday morning, when the sun had risen, they went to St. Mark's. They had been saying to one another, "Who will unlock the doors so we can get in?" When they got to the church, they saw that Pastor Jim's truck was the only vehicle in the parking lot. As they walked toward the door, they saw a young-looking man, dressed in a white all and gold stole, standing in the meditation garden. And they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for our Easter Sunday worship service like we have every year. It will be online. It's not here. Look, here is the empty parking lot. But go and tell your friends, and they will be able to see it on our website, on Facebook, and on YouTube. There you will see it, just as we told you." So they went out and sped from the parking lot, for confusion and amazement had seized them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were confused. The Holy Gospel according to St. James, chapter 20, 21. Hopefully you recognize that as a tongue-in-cheek rewrite of this morning's gospel reading, but it is a story that could very well be true. If you remember, it was last year, just a few weeks before Easter, that we were alerted to this new virus called COVID-19 that had reached pandemic proportions. And because of the fear of spreading this coronavirus, as it's also known, we were warned to limit public gatherings, and many churches, including St. Mark's, canceled services. And so when folks, if they showed up, they found nothing in the parking lot but my truck and me doing the worship service, recording the worship service from over in the meditation garden. Most of us figured within a couple months, things would be back to normal, but here we are. Just over a year later, service is not canceled, but very much limited compared to Easter's of the past. And while our reaction to the canceled worship services may not have been as extreme as the fear and amazement that gripped those women who found the empty tomb, There's one question that we shared with them last year that we are in many ways still asking today. What happens now? You see, the women fleeing from the tomb in fear and silence is thought to be the original ending of Mark's gospel. But today we have at least two alternate endings in most versions of the Bible, apparently because either Mark or some redactors or editors who came after him weren't comfortable leaving Jesus' fate in limbo. Well, thankfully, it was not the end of the story, and neither is COVID-19 the end of the church's story. You see, like Mary, and Salome, those of us who last year experienced the empty parking lots and closed doors, didn't remain silent for long. Word soon got out that St. Mark's was recording their worship services and putting them online, that other churches were live streaming worship services, that even though the services weren't happening in the churches, worship was still happening. The result was that people in their homes and other venues, wherever there was an electronic service available, were worshiping with us on Easter Sunday. And the result, they say, is that we likely reached more people with the good news of the resurrection of Jesus Christ last Easter than any Easter in history. See, God's power to bring life out of death is always amazing to me. Now, of course, his raising of Jesus from the tomb is the greatest display of that power. But we've seen it happen time and again as pronouncements of the death of the Christian church have been proven wrong over and over again. Before his death, Jesus promised Peter and the other disciples that he would establish his church, and even the gates of Hades would not prevail against it. And ever since then, Satan has been doing everything in his power to try and prove Jesus wrong. Now, I'm not saying that coronavirus is the direct work of the devil, but we know that sickness and death in our world is a result of the imperfection of our world, an imperfection that came into the world when Adam and Eve first gave into the temptation of the serpent there in the garden. For centuries now, the church has been threatened by other pandemics, the church has been threatened by plague, the church has been threatened by governments, and the church has been threatened by what is probably the most insidious and dangerous threat of all, the indifference of Christians. You see, long before COVID-19, long before there was any fear of spreading anything other than the common cold by worshiping in person, traditional church attendance had been dropping off. But Christmas and Easter were two times when even those who were most indifferent to Jesus most of the year would still come to church to worship him and celebrate his birth and his resurrection. COVID-19 took away those traditional opportunities for worship in much the same way that Jesus' body was taken away from his followers and laid in the tomb, presumably never to be seen again. But God's power over death was shown in the resurrection of Jesus, and his power to overcome anything that threatens our worship, anything that threatens our life of faith, is shown in the fact that today we have people in the pews. We have people worshiping online. Many people who will worship with us electronically are people who might never have crossed the threshold of our church building on Christmas or Easter or for any other reason. Because of the witness of those women who left the tomb, because of our witness here today, because of the witness of electronic media, the church has grown to encompass the entire world. You know, after Jesus' resurrection, the life of those three women and all Christians who have come after them would never be the same. Jesus' promise to be raised from the dead had been fulfilled. The hope of spending eternity with him in the kingdom of God has become a real possibility for all who believe. And after the threat of coronavirus is over, and it will be over, after this threat is over, life in the church won't be the same. See, many people who at first felt forced to worship remotely because there was no other choice now see it as an opportunity. It's an opportunity for them to join with their own congregation or with congregations all over the world to worship, whether they be at home, in the hospital, in a nursing home, or traveling somewhere to the far ends of the earth. You know, for a few years now, our bishop, Jim Dunlop, has been saying that the church of the future will be different. Now, I doubt that he had any prophecy of the coronavirus or anything else that was going to drive that difference, but he knew, as many others did, that the church of the future will be different, and those words certainly ring true today. And while we often balk at change, it is, as they say, inevitable. And when done right, when done for the right reasons, change can be a blessing rather than a curse. Jesus changed the world when he rose from the dead. Death no longer has the final word. Our in-person worship attendance is not the same as it has been. But in-person worship attendance is not the final word. See, Jesus sent the Holy Spirit to guide and support us in his absence. And I don't see any reason why the Holy Spirit can't work through technology just as well as in person. Now, for those like me who enjoy the traditional worship, who really appreciate the traditional worship, we say, well, it's just not the same. But for others, it is that opportunity to join in worship that they might never have had before. Christ is risen never to die again, and so is the church that bears his name. Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Amen. I invite you to stand as you're able. Hallelujah. Jesus is risen. Trumpets resounding in glorious light. Splendor in land, heaven forever. Oh, what a miracle God has in sight. Jesus is risen and we shall arise. Give God the glory. Hallelujah. Please join with me now as together we confess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in one Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit to bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Praise to you for your power revealed in the resurrection. Fill your church with the power of your love that is stronger than death. Send us to tell the good news wherever death holds sway. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Praise to you for your life that worked in the resurrection. Fill all of creation with your life. Bring it to blossom and flourish. Use it to remind us of your persistent grace. Cultivate our care for what you have made. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Praise to you for the peace made possible in the resurrection. Fill the nations with your peace. Draw people together of all nations and languages. Reveal new possibilities and inspire new beginnings. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Praise to you for the hope of the resurrection. Fill all in need with hope. Those who are afraid or confused, those who are sick or suffering, those who are dying, and those who grieve. We remember especially today Carrie Flegel, Bill Shook, Linda Menton, and others we now name aloud or in our hearts. Assure them of your promises. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Praise to you for the joy of your resurrection. Fill this assembly with joy as we are called your beloved in baptism. Multiply that joy so that we share it at home, at work, and in our community. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Praise to you for your faithfulness revealed in the resurrection. Fill us with trust that we join with all who have gone before us in proclaiming your mercy endures forever. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Each one of you is a part of the body of Christ, and you were chosen to live together in peace. So let the peace that comes from Christ control your thoughts and be grateful. Please share a safe sign of the peace with those near you. The peace of the Lord be with you all. By Jewish hand, let the vineyard be fruitful, Lord, and filled to the brim our cup of blessing. Gather our harvest to the seed of our sowing, that we may be fed with the bread of life. Gather the hopes and dreams of all, unite them with the prayers we offer. Grace our table with your presence, and give us a foretaste of the feast to come. Let us pray. God of love, you call us beloved as children and welcome us to your table. Receive our lives as the gift we are. Abide with us and send us in service to a suffering world.
for the sake of your beloved child, Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior, Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join in our unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you, O God of the universe. Your mercy is everlasting, and your faithfulness endures from age to age. Praise to you for creating the heavens and the earth. Praise to you for saving the earth from the waters of the flood. Praise to you for bringing the Israelites safely through the sea. Praise to you for leading your people through the wilderness to the land of milk and honey. Praise to you for the words and deeds of Jesus, your anointed one. Praise to you for the death and resurrection of Christ. Praise to you for your Spirit poured out on all nations. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With this bread and cup, we remember our Lord's Passover from death to life as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. O God of resurrection and new life, pour out your Holy Spirit on us and on these gifts of bread and wine. Bless this feast. Grace our table with your presence. Come, Holy Spirit. Reveal yourself to us in the breaking of the bread. Raise us up as the body of Christ for the world. Bring new life into us. Send us forth, burning with justice, peace, and love. Come, Holy Spirit. With your holy ones of all times and places, with the earth and all its creatures, with sun and moon and stars, we praise you, O God, blessed and holy Trinity, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray together as Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now let us feast this Easter day on Christ, the bread of heaven. Hallelujah. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. Body of Christ given for you. Christ shed for you. I invite the stand and raise your... The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen us and keep us in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. Life-giving God, in the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, you send light to conquer darkness, water to give new life, and the bread of heaven to nourish your people. Send us forth as witnesses to Jesus' resurrection, that we may show your glory to all the world, through the same Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. May our glorious God grant you a spirit of wisdom to know and to love the risen Lord Jesus. God of light, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Good Christian friends, rejoice and sing. Now is the triumph of our King. To all the world, glad news we bring. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
You are the body of Christ raised up for the world. Go in peace, share the good news.
We will. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.